I'm Howard Sholkin, and welcome to Engagement Matters. As IT vendors evolve their online campaign strategies, the gap continues to grow between what content types and formats a vendor offers and what IT buyers want to make informed decisions. This misalignment jeopardizes sales opportunities. To learn how to appeal to services prospects, IDG asked 70 buying team members to tell us what they prefer and when as they move from consideration to purchase. Joining me today is Bob Johnson, Vice President of Engagement Optimization at IDG Connect. Welcome, Bob.
Hi, Howard.
Could you tell me a little bit more about what the services buyers and prospects told you?
Well, one of the things that we wanted to do with this research was look at the differences that services buyers presented relative to hardware buyers, or software as a service buyers. So in doing that, we wanted to find out what content types they rely on at the different stages of the decision-making process and help match that up with vendors and what they can do to help buyers make better decisions.
How do they view different sources of information?
Well, what's interesting, when it comes to the services buyer, more than any other buyer type, they rely on the view of independent authorities. Independent authorities meaning whether it be advisory service firms or otherwise. So the services vendor needs to make sure that they're focused on that, in addition to the educational and transactional content, which are also very important.
What do you mean by independent sources?
Well, there's a whole variety of them out there, whether they're ones that are doing mostly reports in terms of market trends or market sizing or forecasts. They may be doing independent reviews. But in all cases, what they are trying to do is offer an unbiased view, a level playing field, that the buying team member can look at to get a better handle on how the market really is positioned.
What do service providers have to do to improve their position?
Well, one of the things they need to realize is just like other investment categories, they're getting a failing grade currently in terms of meeting the needs of buyers. They too, as others do, need to boost the relevance of their content up to approaching 60%. If they do that, they can significantly enhance the likelihood of being moved from stage to stage and their overall success.
Bob, there are some interesting differences between what product buyers prefer and what services buyers look for.
Absolutely. We know we've heard for years about services being intangible and make them tangible. So what a services buyer wants is more clarity, more structure. They get that not only through articles, but through reports and white papers. They tend to reach out to their peers in some ways. And as we mentioned before, go for those independent sources.
And Bob, what should they do about market-centric information? And what do you mean by market-centric? Can you give an example?
Well, that's laying the groundwork for what the conditions of a particular market are, why the service is important, how the service is taking over where products may be right now, in terms of how it integrates, in terms of how the different players revolve within that market. Because what someone wants to do, if they're going to consider you as a service provider, they want comfort that from a market orientation, that you're a thought leader, and that you're on top of your game in terms of moving your services forward to stay up with the innovation that they have going on in other technology.
Please explain the importance of ROI calculators.
Well, the fact of the matter is that the services buyer, because of the intangible nature of this, they're looking to look at time savings as well as resource savings. They want to look at process efficiency. So it's a little bit different than the software or the hardware buyer with a more tangible investment. But what they want to do is they want to understand from a ROI standpoint, how the services not only is going to save IT time, but also that they can extend that explanation out into the business functions in terms of how it's going to benefit them.
Look at knowledge bases and how important are they? Explain that.
Well, knowledge bases for the hardware buyer are important, but the services buyer especially, because I know I'm buying your services, but I know at certain times I'm going to have to service myself. And if I'm going to have to do that, I need to know that not only myself within, say, the IT organization, but the users out in the community can access the information that they need on an ongoing basis to leverage the service investment that's being made.
I notice how important customer stories, case studies, are at this phase. Could you speak to that?
Well, case studies continue to be very, very important, but especially important when it comes to services, and we see that by how highly they're rated. The fact of the matter is because it's less tangible, I need case studies that are really going to be aligned with who I am. Therefore, case studies tend to take on a more vertical orientation. They may look at specific business processes rather than just saying, well, they used it and they really like it.
What do they look for in white papers for services that might be different than a white paper for a product?
When you look at a white paper for services, you have to realize that people are trying to understand if your service is going to take the place of an existing service they have. They want to know very clearly how it's going to do. So those types of white papers tend to be very step by step, so I can see exactly how it's going to fit in. They want to also know from a compatibility standpoint relative to our expertise how your organization is going to actually enhance that. So alignment in that area of expertise is very important.
What happens after the evaluation phase?
After the evaluation phase, we basically go to the point where we are looking at the shortlist and we're trying to determine which partner is going to be the best fit for our organization.
What role does evaluation play, or can it play, in a service?
Oh, it plays a big role, because the fact of the matter is that I want to sample. I want to see what you have. I want to know and test that your level one, level two capabilities, your self-support, your maintenance, other things that you do for professional services. I want to understand your expertise. I want to understand your industry knowledge that you have that can be transferred to our people. The evaluation is critical because of the fact that it's less tangible.
Service buyers also want a lot of in-depth information too.
Well, and that's a challenge for the service provider, because how can I give you that in-depth information? But basically, they want to know how your processes work, how you control your quality, how you're continuing to innovate. That in-depth information, therefore, tends to be more process-oriented, value-oriented, or impact-oriented than simply technical.
Bob, you've presented a lot of information in a short amount of time. Could you net it out? What are the three or four most important items?
Well, leverage peer-to-peer when it comes to the actual service buyer as well as the independent authority. Clearly, that's what people are going to do. They're going to go out and ask others who have been there before. The content has to speak how a service is actually delivered and how the relevant technical expertise is going to be applied. Realize that there's a broad group of content, but make sure that you're focused on the process that people are trying to do and how you're aligned with what they have. Buyers want to understand how a service also has been demonstrated to others that have gone before, because that can boost the comfort level and increase the likelihood of purchase.
Bob, thank you for helping us better understand the importance of information during the purchase cycles, and also what is important to the buyers so that the IT providers can be more successful.
Thanks, Howard.
I'm Howard Sholkin, and thank you for joining us with Engagement Matters.